We can use the CIA Triad model to measure up against cybersecurity, making sure that we're approaching cybersecurity from multiple angles. But we can actually add some depth to that CIA Triad model. So in this video, we're going to talk about the Cybersecurity Cube and how it adds depth to that CIA Triad so we can really evaluate cybersecurity and making sure that we cover all of our bases. In this video, we're going to talk about the Cybersecurity Cube. This is what it looks like. We're going to just briefly mention confidentiality, integrity, and availability because we already have discussed that in prior videos. We're going to really get into at rest, in process, and in transit, and then we'll talk about people, processes, and technology. In a prior video, we already talked about the CIA triad. That is confidentiality, keeping things secret, the integrity, making sure that data doesn't change and that it's accurate, and then also availability, making sure that data or those services are up and running. When we think about confidentiality, integrity, and availability, we got to think about the whole process, not just a single part of the process. That is, data is dynamic. It changes, it moves, it migrates. And so how do we protect each one of those areas? Well, we got to think about the states of data. So let's take a very typical setup for, let's say, a web server. Let's say we have a bank of web servers here. So these are web servers. And a lot of times we don't actually store the data on those web servers. We store it on a separate database. So this is a database right here. And so what happens is that these web servers access this database. And let's say you're a client machine and you are requesting, maybe this is a banking site. This is you're getting remoting into your bank information here. And so the client gets to the web servers and requests the information. These web servers don't actually store the banking information on those web servers. They go to the database to grab the information from the database. They bring it in, they process it, and then send it to the client. Well, there's several states of where this data is living at this point in time, where it exists at this point in time. First of all, it's at rest on the database. And so we got to think about security from that standpoint, about what is this data doing at rest. And then it gets processed. So how are we going to secure those processes and making sure that that element is secure? And then it gets moved about. It's in transit. It goes to the client and then gets displayed on the client's machine. So how do we protect the data when it's in transit? So now we start thinking of things in a grid format. That is, how do we keep things confidential when it's at rest? How do we keep things confidential when it's in process? How do we keep things confidential when it's in transit? Same thing with integrity. How do we keep the integrity at rest? How do we keep the integrity when it's in process? What about in transit? And so we can start checking each one of these boxes and thinking about each one of these boxes separately to make sure we've got this covered. So for instance, let's say we want to do encryption. We're going to encrypt things when they are at rest to keep things confidential. Or maybe we use a VPN when it's in transit. But we can also add a third dimension to this, and that is the people, processes, and technology, or PPT. The people, processes, and technology is a third dimension that we can look at to make sure that we're covering what we need to cover. So with this, people are the people that you hire, the skill sets that they have, the abilities that they have. It can be a weak point or a strength for a company. And so that is the people side of this. And the people follow some sort of process, or hopefully they follow some sort of process. Hopefully there's some sort of guidelines. Hopefully there's some guidance, some policies, some procedures that they follow. So a playbook of sorts that they do to do their job. So that is the process part of that. And then there's the technology. The technology is the technologies they use. And we gotta be thinking about vulnerabilities from each one of these standpoints. Are there vulnerabilities to the people side of this? Is there vulnerabilities to the process side? Or is there vulnerabilities to the technology side? So here's where the cube comes into play, because now we can think about confidentiality, but instead of being this humongous thing that we got to think about all these different aspects, we can break it down into smaller components. How does confidentiality come when we're talking about data at rest? Or how about data in process? Or how about data in transit? Not only that, but we can think about what technologies do we implement for confidentiality when it's in transit. We already said confidentiality in transit is going to be a VPN. So we're going to use a VPN, but which technology? Let's do OpenVPN, or maybe it's going to be a Cisco AnyConnect, or there are several different options that we have out there. But we're going to use a technology for that. Well, we got to think about our processes around that. Those technologies get old. We need to update OpenVPN now and then. We need to update our encryption algorithms now and then. So let's think about that cube right there, that process. How are we going to document that? How are we going to implement that? What do we need to think about from a process standpoint when it comes to rolling out these VPNs? Are we doing it with a certificate? Do we have to somehow have a process to hand out those certificates? And then we think about the people side of this as well. When it comes to this solution, how are we going to train our people to use VPN? How are we going to train them to set up VPN? Or are we going to use the IT department to help them set up the VPN? So there's a lot of different aspects to think about. And what this does is it allows us to more comprehensively think about this process. And we've got three dimensions to do that. One, we've got confidentiality, integrity, and availability. So there's three options there. We've got our at rest, in process, and in transit. So 3 times 3, that's 9. And then we got our people, processes, and technology. So 9 times 3, that's 27. So there's 27 areas that we can think about now. It's areas that we already had to think about, but now we have this methodology of logically going through and making sure we have all the bases covered along the way. So that is the cybersecurity cube, and it allows us to take that comprehensive look at cybersecurity and making sure that we roll out a well-designed cybersecurity program.